this is the brainwashing that the British did, that we are not one community. Today, modern science of DNA says we are all of one DNA. Published in, if you don't believe, in University of Mysore's Journal of Genetics or the American Houston University's Journal of Genetics, you can look at the Cambridge University Journal of Genetics. All Indians have the same DNA. Whether it is North Indians, South Indians, East Indians, West Indians. Whether it is Brahmin, scheduled caste, same DNA. There's no difference. The scheduled caste population came as a special situation. Unfortunately, by then we got birth connected with the Varna. As Lord Krishna says in Gita, it has got nothing to do with birth. It has got to do with your gunas. We venerated knowledge and sacrifice at the highest. Gyan and Tyag. And those who practiced that were called Brahmins. Vishwamitra's father and mother were Kshatriyas. But by his actions, he became a Brahmin, a Maharishi. Vedavyasa's mother was a fisherwoman. He became a Maharishi and wrote the Mahabharata. Kalidasa was a Vanvasi. He used to cut the branches of trees. Became the biggest poet of India. He was a Maharishi. Valmiki was a scheduled caste of parents. His parents were scheduled caste. Became a Maharishi after a brief career as a dacoit. So therefore, there's got nothing to do. We are one people. But the intellectual terrorism today, making you believe what you should not believe, or not believe what you should believe, that has made us to think of all us as different people. Even our languages are connected by Sanskrit. That is not acknowledged. Sanskrit is a dead language. It's not a dead language anymore, because it is the language of the future. In the NASA, there's a journal called Journal of Artificial Intelligence. It says, in future, artificial intelligence will grow into a big computer science, and it will be storing knowledge in the computer, and the most appropriate computer-friendly language on this earth is Sanskrit, and it will be stored in Sanskrit.